Hi, Jonathan here. Today is 3rd of March 2021. Right now, time is 9 o'clock. Okay, 9 p.m. And welcome to a quick midweek market report. Now, as you notice that if you watch the Sunday, this is just going to be a quick update to add on to Sunday. So, there's a few things I want to add on right now. So, first of all, you will notice that I'll be jumping around. This week, as of right now, in about 15 minutes, we'll be looking at the ADP non-farm employment change. This Friday will be the non-farm payroll, okay? Just a quick update. March is also a peculiar month in terms of trading hours. Because if you scroll the entire month of March, okay, you will notice that Not this weekend, but next weekend on March 14, it will be a US and Canada daylight saving time shift. That means if you are in Malaysia, Singapore within GMT plus 8, US, New York will be the same time as in this region. So right now it's 9:01 p.m. It will be 9:01 a.m. in New York. Okay, but that will be on March 14. That's where the confusion will start. If you're also trading like London, Germany, it is not next weekend, but it will be on March 28. So you're like, huh? March 28, so it will be like 14 and 28. And if you are in Australia, New Zealand, Australia is on Sunday, April 4, New Zealand is on Saturday, April 13, which is the first weekend of April. There's a plane taking off, landing. There's a plane landing, so apologize for the noise at the background. So that's the peculiarity that usually happen in March. Shifting of the end of daylight saving time, okay? So let's take a quick look at what's going on in the market. So what can go wrong in the market? We got the third vaccine in United States, Johnson & Johnson. We have the stimulus package. The market is like everything is, the bond yield are coming down, so that's why the price are going up, the futures are going up. So what can go wrong? It's just like everything is perfect for the bulls to go higher. Isn't that great? Isn't this the perfect opportunity to just all in? And that's good. Let's see if we got opportunity to alright. So if you take a look, S&P, yesterday we came down. On Monday we have a strong rally higher, beginning first Monday of the month. Okay, just nice, touches the supported by the 50-day simple moving average. Isn't it great? Okay, now see the S&P currently versus the highest price of S&P, but see the VIX currently versus the low of the VIX. Do you notice the VIX low are very far from the lowest low? Yeah, the VIX price movement is expected to be different, okay? But do you notice the, it's not roughly proportional? So it's a sign of caution. So today, Wednesday, I'll bet the biggest news will be everyone is going to watch this company called Tesla. Everyone will be watching this company called Tesla. Futures would have, for price of Tesla, would have already gone higher. Why? Very simple. It's because of Bitcoin. That's currently the current candle in Bitcoin. So it's like, yes, sunrise again. and everyone is into crypto again. So let's see whether Elon Musk did a tweet, if I remember correctly, about 9 hours ago. 9 hours, 10 hours ago, he did a tweet. So if you remember one thing, once upon a time, in a galaxy not far away, you notice that everyone says trade like Warren Buffett, be like Warren Buffett. You want to be like Warren Buffett and you want to trade like Warren Buffett. The new generation, who the heck is Warren Buffett? We don't want to be like Warren Buffett. We want to be like Elon Musk. Oh well. Okay, do remember, what I shared is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. Okay, so right now, let's talk about the market. We take a look at S&P. Actually, you shouldn't be taking a look at S&P. The counter you should be focusing is not S&P. Okay, purposely zoom out. You will notice that something weird about this. We got Dow Jones, we got S&P, we got Nasdaq, we got Russell. Do you notice that Russell is quite strong? Similarly like Dow Jones. S&P, not as strong as Dow Jones, but still strong. But did you notice the Nasdaq, you will notice that we are forming the shoulder, the head, and right now forming the shoulder, which I said on Sunday, YouTube. We are forming that shoulder. So watching out the shoulder to see whether can we go near 13,500 to see whether can we form a nice shoulder. And if it does form a nice shoulder, it will be definitely a lower high. And right now we already got roughly lower low, but because so close, we call it similar low. Target price for this shoulder, head and shoulder, will be about 200. You notice it's quite proportional. So watching it out very, very closely. So that's for index, watching that. Because today, while waiting for the US market to open, Germany DAX is extremely strong. Okay, we did have a breakout higher than this recent high. Okay, see, historical. But now it's starting to come back. So US hasn't start trading in about 1.5 hours. So Germany is waiting for direction right now. Okay, so watching this very closely, we are in the right place. Now the size is right size, waiting for the right shape. Let's see whether can we have a bearish signal happening right now, happening for today's candle. Not at this very moment. This very moment, I'll be watching US dollars. US dollars. US dollars is going up. So very nice bullish candle, like mentioned. Okay, so watching to see whether US dollar can go up. If US dollar can go up, okay, there will be one failure signal. But if US dollar comes down, then I will be looking at dollar Swiss. Right now, no, haven't triggered. US dollar goes up, it continues goes up, this one never trigger. If US dollar comes down, I'll be looking at dollar Swiss. Nice candle right there. Do remember, whatever I shared is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. Okay, which means, hold on, US dollar Swiss will be nicer as compared to dollar yen, because dollar yen, this candle is not big enough. Dollar Swiss is big enough. So that's why you notice the money pot light, the signal didn't appear. See, like this, appear. So that's why, because the candle is not big enough for it to appear. So that's why it didn't appear, okay? So apart from that, basically nothing much, just a quick update. Basically to share with you that crypto is going up. If you want to know when crypto is going up, you notice that in gathering of traders, four times a day, basically the daily market broadcast tells me what is moving. So one glance in this, I know that the mostly Forex are very quiet, world index are somewhat quiet, but crypto is aggressively bullish. So you want to know more how to join this, just go to Telegram, search for Gathering of Traders. Go to Facebook, search by Gathering of Traders and join. Okay, and do remember to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube. So this is just a quick report saying that hey, market is going to moving and expecting short-term bullish, waiting for a bearish signal. I forgot to mention that day about JPM. So on Sunday, JP Morgan. Come on. I was still uploading the graduates material. Just finished the weekly graduates sharing session. Okay, nothing much. You see now forming a bear flag on daily candle. I'm talking about the weekly candle. If you do not know, go to Facebook Gathering of Traders under files, search for a document called Harami and Moneypot Lite. Read that. The strategies are right there. Question is whether you want to read and want to learn. It's only for you to decide. Okay. Copper, which I forgot on Sunday. Copper. Weekly candle. Yesterday was strong bullish. Okay, strong bullish. So I'm now waiting to see whether can we go lower than last week candle. This is a weekly candle. Apart from that, go. Watching to see whether can we go higher than today is Wednesday, Tuesday high. Okay, so I got position in this. So I'll be watching to see whether I can accumulate more gold, but trading signal will be right now, will be see if we can go higher than Tuesday high for entry, and stop loss will be Tuesday low. Okay, so that's the end, and I will elaborate more this coming weekend. So Jonathan signing off. See ya. Stay safe.